All right. Well, it's just me, myself, and I here for this concert, but I'm glad you came. How did you hear about it? Oh, fabulous. Well, great. This is the 50th anniversary of my first paid gig in showbiz or in music on May 4th, 1963. I was in junior high school, and we had a bunch of us got together. The reason I remember the date is because my dad was conducting a program in Elgin, Illinois, and he said, "Do you guys want to play for this during this concert during the intermission? We need some intermission music." We were so excited. We rehearsed for 6 months, and we go, "Oh, May 4th!" We had this date ingrained in our brains, and we were rehearsing. We were just so enthusiastic, and it turns out we played and got $2 a piece for playing this gig. And they also gave us a tape of it. I have a tape of it somewhere. So we were called the Mad Hatters, and we're from Crystal Lake, Illinois. But I don't know if any of the old band is watching the live stream today, but this is for me. I'm just going to play songs that I just like to play. I love Duke Ellington. I'll do a couple of songs that we did on the original concert, and I'm just going to do Duke Ellington now. I'll try not to tap my foot too much. I miss the Saturday dance. Heard they crowded the floor. Well, I'd be lonesome without you. Don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club. Got as far as the door. They would have asked me about you. Don't get around much anymore. Darling, I guess my mind's more at ease. But nevertheless, why stir up memories? I've been invited on dates. should have gone, but what for? It's awfully different without you. Don't get around much anymore. Oh, you're welcome to dance. Saturday dance. Heard they crowded the floor. I got it. It's awfully different without you. Don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club. Got as far as the door. They would have asked me about you. Don't get around much anymore. Darling, I guess my mind's more at ease. But nevertheless, why stir up memories? I've been invited on dates. Got as far as the door. Well, I'd be lonesome without you. I couldn't bear it without you. It's awfully different without you. Don't get around much anymore. Yeah, a little bit of Duke Ellington, one of my favorites. What a crowd we've got here. Wow. I don't know if we can fit any more into this church, but thank you for coming. Appreciate it. I stayed up late making out this list, and that song wasn't even on the list, so I'm probably not going to follow the list. I'm just going to do songs that I like to play. Improvising like a jazz musician. Well, at that first program in 1963, we had a five-piece group. I played piano. We had a drummer, trombone, and two trumpets. And I was also a trumpet player, really, at the time. I was just playing piano. Because you know that joke about a good piano player is hard to find? Did I ever tell you that one? Oh, okay. As long as we've got time to, tell jokes. Well, in the Chicago area, the Catholic Roman Catholic diocese, there's a famous cardinal named Cardinal Bernardine. Did you ever hear him? I really liked him. He was quite the speaker on TV on Christmas Eve once in a while. You can't find him on YouTube or the internet anymore. I don't know.
He played with Charlie Parker, I think.
He played with Charlie Parker.
Yeah.
Just kidding. Anyway, he died. When he passed away, he went to heaven, and St. Peter went there personally to meet him at the pearly gates. And St. Peter said, yeah, we're very happy to have you arrive, and you know, we've got things all ready for you. We'll take a little stroll, and you can see some of the scenery here in heaven, and I'll take you to your apartment. So they walk past this beautiful lake, and there's a house where you can see through the windows, and in there is a grand, beautiful white grand piano, and in there is a guy playing the piano, and it's Duke Ellington. And St. Peter says, yeah, we're very proud to have the Duke here up in heaven. And you can hear, and Cardinal Bernardine hears this lovely music coming from the piano, and they keep on walking, and then they get in, there's a nice neighborhood, but the houses are just a little bit smaller, and Cardinal Bernardine's, you know, admiring the architecture and the surroundings. And then they get a little farther, and there's an area with some nice condos, and she says, yeah, this is a nice, nice area. And then they finally get to a more of an urban area, and St. Peter ushers him into his basement apartment, and Cardinal Bernardine is looking around, and it's okay, you know, but he goes, well, just St. Peter, I mean, this is really nice and everything. I'm not complaining as I'm here in heaven, but what is with the basement apartment? And, you know, I noticed that Duke Ellington, when I arrived in heaven, had this beautiful mansion on a lake. And Saint Peter says, well, you know, up here in heaven, the saints are really a dime a dozen, but a good piano player is hard to find. Okay. Since it's my concert, I can tell my own jokes. Hey! Wow, some of my best friends are here today. Hi, Ron. How you doing? Okay, here's a... This is a tune that was done at the first concert, May 4th, 1963. And since none of the original trumpet players are here, I'm going to do a little trumpet work myself. Okay, I think, with any luck. Jada, 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 jing, jing, jing. Jada, 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 jing, jing, jing. Well, it's a pretty little melody, one that's soothing and appealing to me. Jada, 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 jing, jing, jing. Jing, jing, jing. Thank you. I even remembered the original ending we played. That's the first, I haven't done that since then, probably. Anyway. But, and some of you jazz fans out there might know that Jada was the basis for Sonny Rollins' composition. What was it called? Doxy. Jada, jada. You're probably wondering why Stanley, oh, Stanley is the monkey's name, is here. And we have to have Jane to thank for that, I believe. Jane may be watching. Hi, Jane. Anyway, I actually do a couple of songs with that reference monkeys, so try one of them. Nat King Cole, of course, is one of my all-time heroes, vocalist, pianist, extraordinaire. And this is one of his World War II hits. This is for you, Stanley. The buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off his back. He grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. What's the use of jiving? Ain't no use in diving. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." The buzzer said, "Hey, monkey, you are choking me. Release a hold and I will set you free." The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye. Said, "Your story is so very touching, but it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top." Took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzer tried to throw the monkey off his back. He grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Everybody, straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Oh, cool down, Papa, don't you." One more time. I used to love to play jazz when I finally learned about it when I was about the time of the first gig. We were playing trad tunes like Tiger Rag and Basin Street Blues. Oh, I didn't think music was that bad. It's a siren in the background. Okay. And of course, my dad was a big influence. He was a piano player, and he was the outgoing showman, and I didn't even want to look at the audience when I played. I was such an introvert. So I would even have arguments with my dad, and he goes, "Hey, you got to play out. You got to be the showman, you know. There's no business." You know, he was the show tunes guy, always extrovertish and giving it to the audience. And I would never do that. It took me years and years before I could even talk into the mic besides doing any playing at all. So it was really, really difficult for me. But one thing I did learn from my dad that stuck with me was playing boogie woogie. He was extremely good as a playing boogie woogie. And I'm going to do one of the first little melody was the Hucklebuck, and it was first blues lick I learned when I was really a young kid. So I'm going to do a little bit of boogie woogie, Steve's boogie. Call it. Thank you. Thing here. Yeah. Okay. Well, eventually I got more deeply into the blues and began to really love it. And one of my favorite artists was, never forget good old what's his name. I'm not getting older, am I? Percy Mayfield, who was a blues artist in the early 50s, and did this one, please send me someone to love. Heaven, please send to all mankind understanding, peace of mind. And if it's not asking too much, please send me someone to love. And show the world how to get along. Peace will enter when all hate is gone. And if it's not asking too much, send me someone to love. Each night I stay awake and I count the world's troubles. The answer always seems to be the same. Lest we put an end to this damnable sin, hate will put the world in flame. What a shame, just because I'm in misery. Baby, I don't beg for no sympathy. And if it's not asking too much, please send me someone to love. Each night I stay awake and count the world's troubles. Answer always seems to be the same. Lest we put an end to this damnable sin, hate will put the world in flame. What a shame, just because I'm in misery. Baby, I don't beg for no sympathy. It's not asking too much. Please send me someone to love. If it's not asking too much, someone to love. Do-do-do. Blues. Wow, the time is flying by. So. Yeah, 50 years. Yeah, we were, we didn't do any Beatles songs because we hadn't even heard of the Beatles yet. I think they were on the Jack Parr show. And one of my friends said, hey, did you hear about this group, the Beatles? On the Jack Parr show, they had a little clip of them. And, no, never heard of them. And then I heard one of their songs on the radio. I go, oh, that's really trite. But what did I know? I want you to meet my granddaughter who's here from Flagstaff, Rhea. Rhea, you want to come up and say hello? Yeah. You don't have to sing a song. I just want you to say hi to everybody. This is Rhea. She's 7 years old. She lives in Flagstaff. And I go, do you want to sing a little song? Just part of one? Just a few, couple of minutes, couple of lines? No. Are you too shy? You want to? Okay. I don't know. I don't know the song, so I can't. You're going to have to sing into the mic. Okay. Oop, careful. I don't know what she's going to sing, but. Okay, well, I'll say hi to everybody. You can come back later if you want, okay? If you're too shy to sing right now. Just say hello.
Hi.
All right.
That's that John Cage species, right?
John Cage?
Yeah.
Silence. By the way, there's coffee and donuts. Everybody who's here. We've got coffee and donuts, and should I take a, I'm just gonna take a break, take a breather. Yeah. It's not like you can take it out of my pay.
Yeah.
We used to tell jokes. That first gig I had, May 4th, 1963, my dad was in the Union, so he'd get the Union magazine, and they'd have jokes for musicians in there. And of course, one of the ones is, oh, we're going to be back here again playing this winter because the manager said it'll be a cold day when you play here again. That's, you know, one of these old musician jokes. And then there was another joke that I said, I don't really get this joke, but I'll tell it anyway, and I told it. And my drummer said, you can't tell that joke in front of people. I can't even repeat it. I know what it is, but I'm not going to repeat it. So anyway, it was a double entendre, put it that way. So hey, Ron, do you have a what?
I have a question.
Question? Okay.
Yeah, so 50 years.
50 years, yeah.
I'm telling Nancy 50 years, but you're a young guy.
I'm only 42 now, so I don't know how that, yeah, it must have been a past life.
Before you were conceived, you were a musician.
Just about. Yeah, it was, it's hard to believe. I don't know how that happened, but. So the guys in the band was called the Mad Hatters, which, myself, and then Jim Bonkowski was the drummer, and he was one of the guys I hung around with a lot. And we ended up doing a lot of gigs later on. And he's in southern Florida as a trucking consultant right now. Another guy was Scott Wright, played trombone. He's in North Carolina. He may be watching today. He was a high school principal out in Southern California for many years and then retired. And then...
Who are those?
He was a good musician. He plays guitar and other musicians too, other instruments too. Pardon?
Who were those two trumpet players? Are they still gigging?
The two trumpet players were Steve Reinwand. He changed his name to Billy Panda, and he's a really successful studio musician in Nashville now.
Cool.
And he goes on tour with some of the big names, too.
And
he plays mandolin, specializes in mandolin, I think.
So were you the third trumpet there?
Played piano? And then Steve Fierce, he may be watching, too. He was... trumpet player. He also played bass and other instruments, and we did a lot of gigs after that original band too. And he's president of a company out in Philadelphia. I'm not sure.
Cool.
He's been president of several companies, I believe. And so the guys are still around. We barely kept in touch there. Oh, Susanna, hello. All my friends are here. So, gee, thanks for coming out, everybody. It isn't every day that you get to celebrate your 50th anniversary in showbiz.
Hey, yeah? Have
coffee and donuts, you know, help yourself. It's casual, you know, mill around. You know, it's kind of like a nightclub atmosphere, even though it's 10 in the morning.
So my question about the 50th, how did that happen today? Or is it just this year?
No, 50 years ago today. 50 years ago today.
This is your first gig. 50 years.
This is my first paid gig. We got $2 a piece.
Wow.
It's more than you're making today.
What was it?
What was it?
What was the gig?
Oh, okay. The gig was my dad was the director of a barbershop chorus. He directed church choir, barbershop chorus. He also played piano and organ on weekends. But he said, wow, we need somebody to play during the intermission of our concert. Would you like to do that? Oh, we just were sky high. That's why I remember the date, because we were talking about this date for like 8 months, rehearsing for this concert. And they ended up not only giving us $2 a piece, but we got a tape of it. I've got a tape of it somewhere. I don't know if it's worth listening to. But I'm going to do one of the songs we did then. I played piano, and we had two trumpet players, but I'll try my best to do the trumpet part. This was it. Why won't you come along with me down the Mississippi? We'll take a boat to the land of dreams and steam down the river down to New Orleans while the band's there to greet us. Old friends to meet us, where all the light and the dark folks meet. Heaven on earth, they call it Basin Street. Well, it's Basin Street, is the street where the elite always meet. Down in New Orleans, land of dreams, you'll never know how nice it seems or just how much it really means. So glad to be, yes sirree, welcome's free, so dear to me, where I can lose those Basin Street blues. Won't you come along with me down the Mississippi? We're gonna take a cruise to the land of dreams and steam down the river down to New Orleans while the band's there to greet us. Old friends who meet us, where all the light and the dark folks meet. Heaven on earth, they call it Basin Street. pretty good not playing in 35 years. of course, people sometimes ask me, this is great because I get to play all the songs that I really love to play. Some people ask me what my favorite song is, you know, which is impossible, really. I mean, but this might be kind of spontaneous, but sometimes just to be credible, and because it is possibly my favorite song, I say Corcovado, Quiet Nights of Quiet Stars. Do you want to sing it with me? Susanna Martin is here. We have a little duet of this work. Is there room enough on the bench? For you? Or do you want to sit on that bench? It's being broadcast. Okay, very informal here. Oh, you want to be back there? Okay.
Sing over your shoulder.
Okay, that's sure. Quiet nights of quiet stars,
quiet chords from my guitar,
floating in the silence that surrounds us.
Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams,
quiet thoughts and quiet streams,
and a window looking on the mountains and the sea. How lovely.
This is where I long to be, here with you so close to me. Dreaming of the meaning of life's ember.
I who was lost and lonely,
believing life was only a bitter tragic joke,
have found with you.
Meaning of existence, oh my love.
Num continuum violão, esse amor uma canção, pra fazer feliz a quem se ama. Muita calma pra pensar e ter tempo pra sonhar. Da janela vi-se o Corcovado redentor. Que lindo, quero ouvir doce sempre assim, com você perto de mim, até o apagar da velha chama. E eu que era triste, descrente desse mundo, ao encontrar você eu conheci. Felicidade, meu amor.
Of quiet stars,
quiet chords from my guitar,
floating on the silence that surrounds us.
Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams,
quiet walks by quiet streams,
and a window look this is where I long to be, here with you so close to me, until the final flicker of life's ember. I was lost and lonely, believing life was only a bitter tragic joke I've found with you. The meaning of existence, oh my love, oh my love, ooh, meu amour.
Well, we didn't plan that at all. So thank you, Susie.
All right.
Thank you, dear. Yeah. Thank you. Wow. That's called Quiet Nights of Quiet Stars, or Corcovado, which is the Brazilian title. And Corcovado is the statue in what town is that? Rio. And it's written by Antonio Carlos Jobim, who wrote this one. And we all know the name of that. Yep, 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 yep. My most memorable gig in 50 years. Wow. Gee. This one. What the most? What was the most awkward gig? Okay. Boy. Well, the most memorable gig I ever played and the second most memorable gig I ever played were at the same place, years apart. And it happened to be at Baker's Keyboard Lounge in Detroit. I was hanging around with Marcus Belgrave, who was a trumpet player who played on all the Motown hits. He's very well known among musicians. Ba-ba-ba-da-da-ba, you know, he played all those Motown songs. But he was also a tremendous jazz player. He played in the original Lincoln Center Jazz Orchestra with Wynton Marsalis. So we did two CDs together, but he had never played at Baker's Keyboard Lounge, which is the oldest jazz club in the United States. So finally he got a request to play at Baker's Keyboard Lounge in Detroit, which started in the 30s, and all the great players played there, Miles and Coltrane and you name it. So he got a request to play there, and he asked me to play piano with him, and that was good enough. But then it turns out, because it was the first time he'd played in Baker's, and Detroit was his hometown, the place was just packed with energy sky high. We walk into this place, and from the beginning to the end of this gig, it was just sky high energy, and we played until the law would allow us to play that night, and longer, I think. But it was just a great bunch of musicians, and Marcus was the only one I'd ever played with before, but I think Don Mayberry played bass, who was a legendary Detroit bass player, and he was also on the second most memorable gig, which was many years later. I played with Tony Frank at Baker's Keyboard Lounge, and it was the 75th anniversary, just, I think it was by coincidence, we played this, and because it was the 75th anniversary of Baker's Keyboard Lounge, all the cats, as they say, came from all over to sit in on this gig, and, you know, just well-known, especially in the Detroit area, local guys came in, and it was recorded, and Tony Frank put out this CD in his name, and I'm playing on the 75th anniversary Baker's CD somewhere. I haven't listened to it for a while, but it was pretty cool. Now, the most awkward gig I ever played. I know your people are watching on the internet and you want to hear some music, but hey, it's my anniversary. So, gee, most awkward. I can't even imagine. boy, I've got to think about that. I'm sure there were so many. I try to block them out that. It could have been a wedding or a, well, this was a gig on trumpet. When I was in high school, the local VFW there were a lot of military funerals for the World War II guys, and they took me out of school early, which was great, to play taps for the for the military funerals. So I guess you'd call it a gig. I got paid for it. For doing this, $15 I remember they gave me for playing taps at the military funerals. So I did several of those. I don't know why, but in the 60s, the World War II guys were starting to die. I don't know, whatever. But the guy's name who coordinated all the funerals, and they did the 21-gun salute and all that, he passed away, the guy who was hiring me. So the rest of the guys came up to me and said, "Can you play taps for Wally's funeral?" You know, I said, "It's really sad. This was," and I was somewhat nervous, but it turned out it was about 5 below 0, and I put the mouthpiece up to my lips, and I went, and I couldn't, and I just went like this because I couldn't play taps for his funeral. So I guess that's one of the most awkward. All right. Boy. Oh, boy. Of course, some of my favorite composers are, you know, Cole Porter, Gershwin, and the blues, as well as playing the blues, and Jimmy Van Heusen. This is one of the songs I always liked. So I'm going to do it. I guess I get my inspiration from Frank Sinatra on this one. Well, I took a trip on a train, and I thought about you. Down a shadowy lane, and I thought about you. Two or three cars parked under the stars, and a winding stream. Moon shining down on some little town, and with each beam, the same old dream. And every stop that we made, oh, I thought about you. When I pulled down the shade, oh, I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and looked at that track, the one going back to you. What did I do? I thought about you. Yeah, you're welcome to dance. Train, and I thought about you. Looked down a shadowy lane, and I thought about you. Two or three cars parked under the stars, a winding stream. Moon shining down on some little town, and with each beam, the same old dream. And every stop that we made, oh, I thought about you. And when I pulled down the shade, then I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and I looked at that track, one going back to you. And what did I do?
What did I do?
What did I do? What did I do? I thought about you. Thank you. Gonna do another one for Stanley. Stanley is our little mascot here, thanks to Jane, who may be watching. Hi, Jane, again. A little song about my hometown. Actually, I'm from the suburbs, but don't tell anybody. You keep your New York joys, I'm going to Illinois. Just as fast as I can. You New York women think you make a fool of any man. Play all kinds of games, you will cheat if you can. Use love like a tool, make a man a fool. What a beautiful motto. Got my money, that's it. How can you mind if I split? Going back where a woman really knows the way to treat a man. People are friendly without no hidden plan. It's the best in the Midwest. Real down city full of good folks who come from home. And when I get back, I'll never roam far from my little shy town. Goodbye, farewell. I might see you later. 'Cause I'm going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Can't take you, Stanley. There ain't nothing in Chicago for a monkey woman like you to do. Monkey woman. Chicago, hear some blues. Play some blues. What tomorrow brings.
Tomorrow brings sorrow.
Well, hurry down now, sunshine. See what tomorrow brings.
Tomorrow brings sorrow.
Well, it may bring sunshine. Then again, it may bring rain. 'Cause I am going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Ain't nothing in Chicago for a monkey woman like you to do. And that means you, Stanley. I can't believe it's 11 o'clock already, but I'll do one more. I don't usually take requests, but I like to check my email if there's any. Oh, Jane says thank you for the honoring Stanley for the. By the way, we're going to be doing a Duke Ellington tribute May 26th right here. Sunday, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so we're going to be doing tons of great Duke Ellington songs, and that's going to be neat. Steve Douglas will join me on bass, and we're just going to do, I guess, all Duke Ellington songs. It also happens to be Miles Davis' birthday, so we may throw in a Miles Davis tune or so, or two. Here, I'm going to do a little medley here of Duke Ellington, starting with with Daydream, which it was actually written by Duke Ellington's assistant arranger. What was help me, please. Who was Duke Ellington's main guy who wrote all the songs for him? Who wrote Lush Life and all that? Billy Strayhorn. Thank you. I knew that. You know, I couldn't be getting older, could I? No. Toronto. Thank you. drum solo. Thank you for coming, everybody. Another 50 years, yeah. Thank you. That's my brother, Brother Lou. No, my brother in spirit.
Yeah, we want
another
one more.
Okay. Probably want a fast one. Old-fashioned, 1963, I love the moonlight, I love the old-fashioned things, the sound of rain upon the window pane, the starry song that April sings, this year's fancies, our passing fancies, sighing sighs, holding hands, these my heart understands. I'm old-fashioned, but I don't mind it. That's how I want to be, as long as you'll agree to stay old-fashioned with me. This is really old-fashioned. Fashion things, the sound of up on the window pane. Starry song that April sings. This year's fancies are passing fancies, but science is holding hands. These my heart understands. I'm old-fashioned, but I don't mind it. That's how I want to be, as long as you'll agree to stay old-fashioned. To stay old-fashioned with me. Rhea, come up. Come up here, Rhea. Thank you all for coming. I'm really especially happy to be celebrating 50 years in showbiz with my granddaughter from Flagstaff, my 7-year-old granddaughter, Rhea. Yeah. So thanks for coming to my concert. That really makes me feel good that you came to hear Papa play. Yeah, thank you. Okay. Coffee and donuts are still free. In another 5 minutes, we're going to start charging for them, so. Thank you.